Are you ready for this?
Good morning.
Outside the Etihad today, we're going to be celebrating City's victory. And flipping heck, what a match. 4-0, beating Real Madrid. I can't believe I'm giving you that score. Not that you heard it for the first time, but you know what I mean. Can't believe we're saying that. 4-0, Manchester City beat Real Madrid last night, which means they are going to the Champions League final. Is this year their year? Or are they going to be winning the treble? Lots of people seem to think so. Sorry if you're a red. Of course, we've got the FA Cup final as well. But as you would expect, you know, if United had got to the Champions League final, we'd be doing exactly the same. So we are going to be celebrating City this morning. If you watched the match, if you were there, get in touch with me now. Let me know how you're feeling. 81333. Start your text message with the word Manc. You can WhatsApp me as ever on the show on 08000 321 333. Again, start your WhatsApp message with the word Manc. It's got me thinking today about our own personal greatest sporting victories, maybe our own sporting achievements in our our life. So, okay, you may not have reached the Champions League final, but perhaps you did really well in the 100 metres at school. Maybe you were in the netball team and you won the Greater Manchester Championship. I don't know. I'm looking to hear from you today. What is your personal greatest sporting achievement? Maybe you've run a race this Sunday. It is the Great Manchester Run. So that is taking place, yeah, this Sunday. They've got a 10K and a half marathon. Maybe you've completed one of them before. Maybe you did the couch to 5K. Let me know, please, your personal greatest sporting achievement. That's what I'm asking you today. 81333. Start your text with the word Manc. The WhatsApp number is 08000 321 333. Start your WhatsApp with the word Manc. On the way, we are going to be speaking to Mark back at the Etihad, but I wanted to start the hour with this. The show where Kieran, our colleague, he is the Carl Pilkington of Radio Manchester. He's pretty weird, really. That's the best way of describing Kieran. He won't mind me saying that, I don't think. Just the way he sees the world is unlike anyone that I've ever met. So we put our heads together and thought, right, let's make the most of it. Let's get Kieran, who is a Gen Z, to watch a film or a TV show and describe it in a way that only Kieran can. We gave you the first clue. And, well, let's just say you still haven't got it from that.
How could a school with such prestigious students be suffering from such a claustrophobic cafeteria? Poor interior design.
Then we gave you a second.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Those are two clues from a film or a TV show. We're on day number 8. You still haven't got it right. Are you going to do it today?
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Okay, thank you. Kieran, the wrong answers so far, there's a lot of them, so hang on to your horses. It's not Fame, it's not Blues Brothers, it's not When Harry Met Sally, it's not Please Sir, The Boarding School, The Dead Poets Society, it's not High School Musical, Waterloo Road, or Saved by the Bell.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Okay, it's not the Harry Potter films, it's not Step Up, The Big Bang Theory, Beverly Hills 90210, it's not The Queen, Teen Wolf, Twilight. It's not Only Fools and Horses, Harry Potter franchise, none of those. It's not The Police Academy, Dinner Ladies, Friends.
How could a school with such prestigious students be suffering from such a claustrophobic cafeteria? Poor interior design.
It's not The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air and it is not Friday the 13th. What is The Morning Glory, please? What is the story? 0800 218 2255. Text me on 81333. Start your text message with the word Manc. Come on, you can do it today. We're going to nail it. What is the film or TV show that Kieran is describing? You've got until 7 o'clock to get your answer in. Otherwise, it's another crazy rollover scenario. Let's get involved now.
This is for my homemade. This is
Lady Gaga and Ariana Grande. But let's cross to the Etihad Stadium. Mark, we've sent you out and about this morning. You're outside the studio. You've been let loose.
I've been let loose, yeah. Good morning. The sun is just starting to rise here, Anna, but I don't think the party has stopped too long ago, because it was quite extraordinary what we saw here last night, wasn't it? It was absolutely remarkable, and if you're a Manchester City fan, I would not blame you if you've not slept after that, because the adrenaline of it. How do you sleep after that?
I don't know. Right, when we were talking about predictions and stuff yesterday, I thought, do you know what? Like you say, maybe 2-1, but like, as you say, extra time. 4-0. When that fourth goal went in, the scream that I let out, I was like a banshee. I think all of Bury heard it.
Yeah, it was. I mean, no one would have predicted that scoreline. I mean, that's the thing, isn't it, about this night. Manchester City have had great European nights before. Obviously, they've been to the final of this competition before, but they haven't played like that against a team of that quality. I mean, that's Real Madrid. They just demolished out there. That isn't with the greatest respect, you know, sort of a team at the bottom end of the Premier League, a Bournemouth or a Southampton. That's Real Madrid, 14-time European champions, the kings of Europe, the team of the century, as they like to call themselves. And Manchester City absolutely played them off the park. They were unbelievably good last night. Football from another planet is how I've heard that first half described. And Madrid just couldn't get out of their own half. They couldn't get near them. City were so good in possession. And, you know, they created so many chances. They could have won by more as well last night. They were so controlled. It was just so impressive. And, you know, I think you'd be... Well, you wouldn't find many bookies that would bet against Manchester City going on to win the lot now, because it just feels like they've got the momentum. And yeah, it's so exciting if you're a City fan, what's going to happen over the next few weeks.
What about if you're a Red watching last night?
That's a different matter, I would say. Yeah, it's no coincidence that Joe McGrath's not with us this morning. I think he's booked the day off deliberately. I guess from a Reds, United point of view, that they've got the chance to stop them doing the treble, haven't they, in the FA Cup final? So they can stop this themselves. But at the moment, it looks like City are going to win the Premier League. They need one more win to do it. I think most people would expect them to get that against Chelsea on Sunday. They are obviously into the Champions League final, where they will be big favourites against Inter Milan. And so, yeah, if Manchester United want to stop City equaling the treble that they won back in 1999, I reckon they're going to have to beat them at Wembley. Mm-hmm. And judging by what we saw last night, that is going to be very difficult to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Mark, we'll cross back to you in the next 15 minutes. Thank you so much. He is live outside the Etihad all this morning. If you're a Blue and you want to say hello, give him a wave, stop by. I'd love to chat to you. But we are asking you today on the show, what is your personal greatest sporting achievement? I'm not saying that you've made it to the Champions League final and you're heading to Istanbul. I'm saying that you may have won, I don't know, javelin at school. Maybe you made the team for badminton when you were 16 years old. Maybe you continue to do really well in your grassroots netball team. Whatever it is, please, what is the greatest sporting achievement that you've done? Maybe you've run a 5K, a 10K. It's a great Manchester run on Sunday. Maybe you're training for that. Get in touch with me now, please, 81333. Start your text message with the word Mank. I'm asking you for your greatest sporting achievement, please. Right, I will play your Lady Gaga on the way right now. Let's have a look on Greater Manchester's roads. Few things to be aware of today, starting on the train, Salford Central Station. That's still closed because of ongoing engineering works. In Chorlton, you've got temporary lights on Nell Lane. That's near St Werburgh's Road because of gas main work. And in Knutsford, temporary lights on Mobley Road at Merriman Avenue. That's because of electricity work there. Your travel from BBC Radio Manchester. More in 20 minutes.
In the hot seat.
I'd like to ask you if there's any way you can get involved in our fight.
Your weekly hotline to the Mayor for Greater Manchester.
Well, what sort of budget do you have to promote Manchester?
Andy Burnham answers your questions.
We've not had buses that can get us directly to any of the major hospitals.
In the hot seat.
You know how much we value the hot seat, Mike? Because it gives me feedback on things that matter to people.
This morning from 10.
BBC Radio Manchester.
Yeah, Andy Burnham is back after a number of weeks. We had the local elections. He was off last week as well. If you do have a message for the Mayor of Greater Manchester, if you'd like something addressing, make sure you're listening from 10 o'clock here on BBC Radio Manchester, and he will be answering your questions. Playing Morning Glory, bit of fun. Day number 8. Kieran, the Carl Pilkington of Radio Manchester, has watched a film in... and described the film or TV show in a way that only Kieran can. He's given us two clues. Here's clue number one.
How could a school with such prestigious students be suffering from such a claustrophobic cafeteria? Poor interior design.
Thank you. Clue number two.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Right. Good morning to Jen in Altrincham, who says, morning, Anna. Is the answer X-Men?
No.
Jen, it isn't, I'm afraid. Keep them coming, please. Are you going to get it today, or is it going to be another crazy rollover scenario? You know what to do. Pick up your phone, 0800 218 2255. Text me on 81333. Start your text message with the word Mank.
I didn't ask for a free ride. I only asked you to show me a real good time. Showed me nothing at all.
see I'm about to fly. Rain on me, tsunami. Head up to the sky. I'll be your galaxy. I'm about to fly.
Lady Gaga, Ariana Grande, BBC Radio Manchester, 6:25. Good morning, Anna Jameson and the team with you. Good morning to Tina, who says, well done to the Blues last night, Real Madrid, what a team to be. Also, I always did really well at cricket, rounders and football. So they're my greatest sporting achievements. Thank you so much, Tina. Keep them coming, please. What is your personal greatest sporting achievement? It could be anything from the egg and spoon race to a marathon. Get in touch with me now, 81333. Start your text message with the word Mank. Lots of guesses coming in for Morning Glory. Here's clue number one.
How could a school with such prestigious students be suffering from such a claustrophobic cafeteria? Poor interior design.
Thank you, Kieran. Clue number two.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Thank you very much. Good morning to Paul in Hanforth, who says, hi, Anna. Is it Beverly Hills 90210? That one. I'll say the wrong answers again so you've got them. So it's not Beverly Hills 90210, Friday the 13th. It's not The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Teen Wolf, Friends, Dinner Ladies, Police Academy. It's not any of the Harry Potter franchise. It's not Twilight, Only Fools and Horses, The Queen. It's not The Big Bang Theory, Step Up, Grease, Saved by the Bell, Waterloo Road, High School Musical. It's not The Dead Poets Society.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hate, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
It's not Please Sir, The Boarding School, When Harry Met Sally, Blues Brothers or Fame. What is the story, please? 0800 218 2255. I'd love to hear from you if you're a Blue today and you're waking up feeling pretty glorious. Get in touch with me now and continue with your greatest sporting achievements as well. Coming up, we're also going to be talking about what's happened in New York in the last 24 hours. You may have seen an alert come through on your phone to say that Harry and Meghan and been involved in a so-called car chase around New York involving members of the paparazzi. The couple claim they were involved in a near catastrophic chase after that award ceremony on Tuesday. We're going to be bringing you up to date with the very latest on that. Thankfully, there were no collisions, injuries or arrests, but we will bring you up to date with everything you need to know really as to what's happened there and what the consequences have been. So make sure you're listening after seven. Also, got some Harry Styles to play you on the way after the news and sport. Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, Aswad, ABBA. Right now it's George Benson on BBC Radio Manchester. Good morning. George Benson, BBC Radio Manchester. The time now is 6:31. With the news headlines for Greater Manchester, it's Paul.
Manchester City fans are celebrating reaching the Champions League final and keeping alive their dreams of the treble. The Blues hammered the European champions Real Madrid 4-0 last night in the second leg of their semi-final. They'll now meet Inter Milan in the final in Istanbul next month. Mark's got much more on that to come in the sport next. Our region's water companies apologising for the amount of sewage flowing into the seas and rivers. United Utilities, SAND, along with its counterparts across the country, admits they fail to do enough to stop the pollution. Nationally, the companies say they'll invest £10 billion to tackle the problem, but that could mean bigger bills. Claims by Prince Harry and Meghan that they were involved in a near-catastrophic car chase by photographers are being denied. A US news agency insists that isn't true, and the New York Police Department says there were no collisions, injuries or arrests. And RHS Bridgewater in Salford is celebrating its second birthday today. It's welcome near nearly a million visitors to the gardens in Worsley. The weather Thursday's looking mainly dry and bright, plenty of sunshine, and it's getting warmer ahead of the weekend. Highs of 17 Celsius.
Mark has the sport live from outside the Etihad, and all you can say after that, Mark, is wow.
Yeah, good morning, Anna. The sun has risen here in East Manchester after the night that Manchester City fans never wanted to end. I can see some of the satellite TV trucks starting to be packed up as the world's media and football fans everywhere try and come to terms with what they watched last night. City didn't just beat Real Madrid, they demolished the 14-time European champions 4-0 to set up a date with Inter Milan in the Champions League final.
De Bruyne through here for Bernardo Silva! This is Ilkay Gundogan, the angle's tight. It comes to Bernardo again! And then De Bruyne, right-footed, clips in delivery. Let's go up! Oh, the ball goes in! Well, here is Mahrez. Foden will turn. Wants to lay it, Alvarez! You can go to Turkey now, Manchester City fans!
That first half performance was football from another world. The Blues sealed a 5-1 aggregate win to avenge the heartbreak of last season's late collapse in the Bernabeu. City boss Pep Guardiola, who spent the night punching the air and even at one point blowing kisses to his players, says his team had to swallow the poison of last year and believes they deserve their place in the final.
Football and sport obviously give you another chance. And when the draw with Madrid, I said, yeah, I want it. I want it because then I think today was there, everything. The energy that we had last season during 1 year, that being criticized these players, but didn't have character, didn't have anything. When we lose because it's football, today was there, and I'm very pleased for the whole organization, for the German owner, especially the players and all the staff.
City women's defender Esme Morgan was part of our big match commentary team alongside Mike Maignan just over the road last night. She couldn't believe how dominant they were.
They never ever looked like they were in trouble or looked bothered or worried by Madrid's threat. And these are the 14 times champions of Europe. City looked as if they were the 14 times champions of Europe.
That was a humbling night for Madrid and their boss Carlo Ancelotti. On the night he surpassed Sir Alex Ferguson's record for the amount of games managed in the Champions League, he admitted though that the Blues were just far too good for them.
I think that tonight Man City deserved to win because they played better than us. And so last season was different. This season they deserved to reach the final and to fight for the final. They were better than us, as we were better than them last season.
A raucous atmosphere at the Etihad and a really emotional one for the City fans as well. These Blues quarters on the big match verdict.
I've been a fanatic all my life and tonight is the greatest night of my life. Everybody played part tonight and I'm just proud to be a Blue.
At this moment in time in my life, I'm getting carried away and I don't care. We've come this far. Why can't we win it?
I've cried at the birth of my both children and I think I'm going to cry again.
There is a brand new episode of our City podcast, We're Not Really Here, available for you now on BBC Sounds. A very giddy Mike Minor, Natalie Pike and Esme Morgan recorded that after the game last night. We'll play some of that a little bit later this morning. Lots more reaction to come with Anna at breakfast between now and 10. Away from the Etihad, Michael Carrick's Middlesbrough suffered disappointment in the semi-finals of the Championship playoffs. They lost 1-0 on aggregate to Coventry, who will now face Luton for a place in the Premier League. That game at Wembley is in 10 days' time. And Chelsea have moved 2 points clear of Manchester United at the top of the WSL. That was after a big win away at West Ham last night. Arsenal won 4-1 at Everton to consolidate their place in the Champions League spots.
Thank you very much. OK, so have you spotted a Blue fan yet? Any City fans at all? Or are you completely isolated?
I mean, there's a few people going past on bikes. I'm not sure if they're City fans or not, but that's about all the traffic there is around here at the moment. It's quiet, but I don't blame City fans for still being in bed, because I'm sure a few of them had a couple of drinks after that game to celebrate.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
We were texting
just a special, special night for the club.
Yes, yeah, sorry, mate. We were texting last night, weren't we? And we were saying this is probably going to be their year now. Like, there's... It's going to be pretty difficult to think otherwise.
Yeah, I think the way that they're playing at the moment, particularly in that first half last night, it just feels like it's all coming together at the right time. And, you know, for Pep Guardiola as well, he's won every other trophy with Manchester City apart from this one. This is the one that they've craved for so long. It's the one that he's craved as well, Anna, because he hasn't won this since he won it with Barcelona against Manchester United in 2011. And I think most people would regard him as the best manager in the world. So for him to go 12 years without winning the Champions League just shows how difficult it is. So I think it was a really emotional night for him as well last night. I've not really seen him like that on the touchline before. And I think it's almost a culmination of everything that the club's been trying to do since 2008. It feels like this is their best ever team. They're playing the best football that they've played probably under Pep right now. And three games from greatness. I think we felt this was coming, but it's only actually after last night that we can stand here this morning and say they are three games away from greatness. One more win in the Premier League, a win over United in the FA Cup final, and of course a win against Inter Milan in Istanbul means that City will win the treble. I mean, obviously, there's a lot of ifs there, but yeah. I mean, what a position to be in at this point in the season.
I know, and what a scoreline as well. 4-0, my word. Listen, Mark, we're going to be chatting to you all this morning. If you are, I don't know, maybe you live near the Etihad, maybe you live in Beswick or Clayton, Miles Platin, Newton Heath, pop down, give Mark a hello. I'm sure he'd love to chat to you. We are going to be catching up with you again in the next 20 minutes and talking more about this after 7. We are playing Morning Glory right now as well. We're on day number 8. Lots of guesses coming in. Kieran has described a film or a TV show. Good morning to Terry from Tilsley, who says, "Hi Anna, is the answer to today's Morning Glory St Trinians?"
No.
It is not. I am so sorry. Terry, well done though. Keep them coming if you think you know the answer. Ian in Bagley, good morning. Hi Anna. Is the answer Nativity? Nativity, what do you think the Morning Glory is? Please, we've got to get it today. It's day number 8. You've got 10 minutes. Get involved. 0800 218 2255. Here's clue number 1 again.
How could a school with such prestigious students be suffering from such a claustrophobic cafeteria? Poor interior design.
Clue number 2.
This Jason guy gets a lot of hurt, but personally, I don't think he gets enough. Go shave your back, Jason.
Right, OK. 81333, start your text message with the word Mank. What is the answer, please? You've got 10 minutes. Harry Styles to play you on the way.
The sound of Manchester.
Manchester. Anna Jameson at breakfast.
BBC. Radio Manchester.
To be aware of in Chorlton, temporary lights on Nell Lane, so that's near St Werburgh's Road because of gas main work. It's slow on the A57 Hyde Road and Mottram Moor in Longdondale. It's going to take you 10 minutes to get through there. And there's minor delays on the East Didsbury line on the trams because of vandalism. Your travel from BBC Radio Manchester, more in 20 minutes.
Making a difference.
BBC Radio Manchester.
She just wants to help people. She made a difference just to one person's life today, and that has been worth going just for that one thing.
I'm actually really quite humbled because I'm not anything special. I just thought that I could make a difference.
I listen to you lot a lot because you all keep me saying, ringing and having a napper.
Making a difference in Greater Manchester.
I just want to make people smile. That's all I want to do.
BBC Radio Manchester.
Trying to find a better way.
Today, I bet you giddy as a kicker.
Oh, I mean, I was very relaxed yesterday, and I said on Talking Balls, but I don't understand why I'm so relaxed. I'm worried that I'm so relaxed. But the way they came out, it was just unbelievable, and I just didn't understand why. I thought in the second half, Real Madrid would come out and really go at us, and they just didn't. And I don't know whether it was the froze or whether it was we were just too good. I thought KDB was struggling a bit. He did look exhausted, but unbelievable. And Bernardo, what a player. I mean, and Walker. Bernardo was man of the match, but they all could have been.
Yeah.
And having beaten Bayern Munich and beaten Real Madrid the way we did, we've got to win the championship.